realistic. Making this gamifying is really, you know, taking the judging system as serious as possible. Judges are being paid this year. This isn't like something we want to, you know, just throw to the side. This has got to be serious. And then if I'm paying you and you f***ing around, you're going to get your ass fired. And we find the next person that wants to get paid to watch battles. So, you know, that's it, man. Yo, Eric, I'll answer your question. How does Real Deals title play into this? We're still going to be holding events. You know, the season is one thing. We're still going to be throwing all sorts of shit. You know what I mean? But the season is definitely primary focus. You know what I mean? Really, this is, you know, it's going to exit. Like, the reason for the season is because Twitch is pushing this, like, way more than before. You know, they're really onboarding this to make this as big as possible. And I'm excited for it, man. The f***ing front page promotion the battle rappers are going to get. We're just really creating our own lane. So I really f*** with it. I think the season is the best step we could have taken rather than just throwing random ass events and trying to compete in everybody else's lane. Everybody want to do King of the Dot versus this guy or compare us to them. Like, don't compare us to nobody, man. We set our own f***ing lane. We've been innovating in battle rap since day one. Themed events, team events, beatbox battles, two versus twos when everyone was calling them corny and shit like that. And then what happens, right? Now everybody on 2-on-2 shit. So I don't go f*** about it, man. Don't be saying we copy no one. Don't be saying none of that corny ass shit, because motherfuckers be copying us and try to play some revisionist history and make it seem otherwise. You know, the original Grand Prix was in 2009 before other leagues even existed. So can miss me with all that corny ass shit. Straight up, man. We've been trendsetting in battle rap. Other people try to repaint the picture because that's the picture they want y'all to see. They can't stand the fact that we actually innovating and doing that. It hurts them. So they try to repaint the picture and you know, make it seem a different way. At the end of the day, you know, they concerned and they worried. And that's why they, you know, got to tell people they can't fuck with us if you got to rock with them. I don't care no more, man. We on our own lane. We doing our own shit. And we don't want to fuck with y'all. You know what I mean? So telling people that if they rock with us, they can't fuck with you, suck a dick and go fuck yourself. Because at the end of the day, that's who y'all you're going to have left at the end of it. We doing this shit for the culture. We doing this shit for real. We doing this shit to help gamify battle rap and make this shit legit for everybody, man. We want to make this entertaining. We want to put this back in the hands of the skill. And we're going to have fucking fun doing it, straight up. You know what I mean? We work hard and everybody here earned their shit. The battle rappers on King of the Dot, they earned their shit. You know, so that's just what it is, man. Straight up. I'm having fun with this shit. I don't care no more. You know what I mean? If I were to ever jump on and school half these people, like, f***ers don't even know the history of battle rap, bro. It's funny. I'm dead ass serious, though. You know what I mean? Get Uncle Rock to drop the interview. I had to teach them all about the history of New York battle rap. A lot of people don't even know a lot because they weren't involved in the culture back then. I've been in this culture since I was 12 years old. You know what I mean? I was winning battle competitions when I was 14 years old, man. Before anybody knew shit, I was taking a bus to Cincinnati, taking buses to Ottawa, taking buses to New York, missing high school to go battle when there was 30 people in a in a pub. You would show up like, you know, not even knowing what beat you're going to get, bro. I'd show up. I'd take a fucking 6-hour bus ride and the motherfucker would play Bone Crusher as my beat. And I'd be all depressed on the bus ride home. But, you know, that's why we're doing this shit, man. This is what we love. We've been involved in battle rap for a long time. Everybody in this culture, man, you know, and that's the word, man. We're going to have fun with this shit. King of the Dot is going to succeed this year. We're going to kill shit. And I'm hyped for it, man. So, hell yeah. Yeah, straight up, man. D-Bar, bro. I was probably like 16 years old when I was out there battling in Ottawa and everything like that. 15, 16, man. You know, by the time I started King of the Dot,